The Type 052D destroyer is a class of guided missile destroyers being deployed by the Chinese People Liberation Army Navy. China plans to build around 18 of these, and 9 have been completed. The Arleigh Burke class of guided missile destroyers is the United States Navy's multifunctional destroyer, capable of performing a wide range of missions. U.S. plans to build around 76 of these, and 66 have been completed. In any future conflict, these ships will play a major part in deciding the battle at the seas. In this video, Defense Updates compares the Type 052D and Arleigh Burke class based on 5 important parameters and draws an unbiased conclusion. Let's get started.
Number 5.
Type 52D uses essentially the same hull as its predecessor, the Type 52C. Its hull is slightly smaller at 154 meters, but it displaces around 7,500 tons when fully loaded. It has a speed of around 30 knots and a range of 3,800 nautical miles, approximately. The designers of Arleigh Burke incorporated lessons learned from the Ticonderoga-class guided missile cruisers. It has a length of 155 meters, but displaces around 9,800 tons, making it significantly bigger than the Type 52D. Arleigh Burke has a speed of around 31 knots and a range of around 4,400 nautical miles. The larger size enables the Arleigh Burke class to have more range and endurance. It also provides better headroom for future upgrades. So, in this category, Arleigh Burke class has the slight advantage.
Number 4.
The Arleigh Burke class of guided missile destroyers is the United States Navy's first class of destroyer built around the Aegis combat system and the SPY-1D multifunction array radar. The AN SPY-1D is deployed on the first 40 destroyers, and AN SPY-1DV is deployed on the subsequent destroyers, starting with DDG-91 in 2005. Each of these radar systems has 4 radar antenna faces and is electronically controlled. These radars have a range of around 310 kilometers against decent-sized aerial targets and around 20 kilometers against sea-skimming missiles. The primary radar, the Type 348, is similar in arrangement to the SPY-1 radars. It's a dual-band AESA which has 4 square panels mounted on 4 sides of the superstructure. This radar is said to have a range of 250 kilometers against large aerial targets. Its performance against sea-skimming missiles is not correctly known, but is thought to be around 10 kilometers. Though Chinese radar is a very strong performer, AN SPY-1D built by the US is widely considered to be the best radar system, along with the Israeli-made MF Star. Also, AN SPY-1D is very tightly integrated with Aegis combat system that enables better information processing. Hence, slight advantage goes to the Arleigh Burke class.
Number 3.
Type 52D has 64 VLS. The Type 52D can carry 48 surface-to-air missiles on a mission. The primary one is the HQ-9B, which has a long-range area defense capability. It has a slant range of 200 to 300 kilometers. The secondary air defense is provided by HQ-16 SAM, which has a range of 50 kilometers. The last-ditch anti-missile capacity is provided by Type 730 close-in weapon system. Arleigh Burke class has 96 cell MK-41 VLS, of which 60 can be dedicated to air defense. RIM-161 Standard Missile 3 can be deployed in them for Aegis ballistic missile defense. It has a range of 2,500 kilometers against fast incoming ballistic missile. RIM-66 Standard MR is present for anti-aircraft roll. These have a range of about 170 kilometers. 20mm Phalanx close-in weapon system is present. Both vessels also deploy multiple guns for short-range engagement. In traditional air defense against aircrafts and drones, both are more or less equally competent. Arleigh Burke having more missiles, but Type 52D having missile with better range. Arleigh Burke class is uniquely paced, having the ability to take out ballistic missiles, giving it a distinct advantage.
Number 2.
Of the 64 VLS, if 48 are equipped for air defense, 16 can be used for anti-ship YJ-12 missile. The range of the missile is said to vary from 220 kilometers to around 350 kilometers, depending on flight profile. The missile reaches supersonic speeds of more than 2 Mach during the final dive towards its target. Like Type 52D, the Arleigh Burke can be configured as permission, but because it has more VLS, it can carry more missiles. 36 of the 96 VLS can be allocated for anti-ship warfare. The main anti-ship missile of the Arleigh Burke class is the Harpoon 2ER. Harpoon 2ER has improved turbojet engine with electronic fuel controls, giving it much greater range when compared to its predecessor. It has a capability to reach targets at a maximum distance of 124 kilometers and has subsonic speed of 0.7 Mach. Clearly, the Type 52Ds has a distinct advantage in quality, but Arleigh Burke carries more missiles. In case of a conflict, the Type 52D has an advantage as it is more likely to land the knockout punch.
Number 1.
Type 52D uses HSJD-9 hull-mounted sonar as well as HSJG-206 towed array sonar. These have capacity similar to those used in Arleigh Burke class. Type 52D's main ASW weapon is two triple mountings for a total of 6 lightweight torpedo tubes. These have a range of around 15 kilometers. The Arleigh Burke class uses AN-SQS-53C sonar array and AN-SQR-19 tactical towed array sonar. Arleigh Burke class main anti-submarine warfare weapon is two triple torpedo tubes for lightweight torpedoes like Mark 44, Mark 46, and Mark 50. These have a range of around 15 to 18 kilometers. Arleigh Burke class has two hangars for ASW helicopters like Seahawk Lamps 3. Overall, the ASW reach of Arleigh Burke class is better due to the ability of deploying two helicopters instead of one in Type 52D. Arleigh Burke class performed better overall, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it will win against the Type 52Ds every time. Victory in a battle depends on other factors too, like the training of the crew in maneuvering, damage control, and the tactics employed by the captain. It must be noted that currently the US has 66 of these against 9 of China. It's a huge numeric advantage. For every one Type 52D, there are 7 Arleigh Burke class.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.